This is the second video for MA 1001. We're going to talk about intervals and absolute values. So when we think about intervals, we could ask ourselves, if we have the number 3 and number 5 on the number line, what are the numbers in the middle, in between 3 and 5? Which numbers are in the middle? But there's more than one notion of being in the middle. Well, do we include 3 as being in the middle between 3 and 5 or not? So we'll use some notation. We'll write square bracket 3, 5 to mean the set of all numbers x such that 3 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 5. And then round brackets 3, 5 to mean the set of numbers x such that 3 is less than x is less than 5, so not including 3 or 5. Then we can have a square bracket 3, round bracket 5, and that's round there, is the set of x such that 3 is less than or equal to x is less than 5. And then we have, of course, round bracket 3, square bracket 5, is the set of x such that 3 is less than x, and that's less than or equal to 5. So here we include, with the square brackets, we include 3 and 5, just include 3 but not 5, 5 but not 3. So that's the notation that we'll use. We can draw this. Of course, it works for other numbers besides 3 and 5. We can draw these in different ways. One way to draw it is to actually think of putting the parenthesis right on top. Put a square bracket here, and here's the 5, and a round bracket, and that means exactly square bracket 3, round bracket 5. In a picture, some people would prefer to draw it, and I don't mind which way, you can draw it any way you like, that this would be a solid dot at the 3 and a little round dot at the 5, and maybe put some hash in the middle to make it clear that that's what you mean. That's the same thing as that. So these two pictures represent the same, have the same meaning, and whichever one you prefer is fine with me. There's another question about intervals. We could have an interval that starts at 3 and then goes up forever, all the way on forever. And that interval we'll write as square bracket 3, if it's going to be a solid dot there, including the 3, and a round bracket infinity. And for infinity, we always have to use a round bracket, because infinity is not a real number. So we won't really allow infinity into into this module at all. We won't learn about infinity. We won't do arithmetic with infinity. We keep infinity out, and so that's why we have to put a round bracket there always, so that we don't end up having to deal with infinity itself directly. Similarly, we could look at a picture which goes all the way up to 5, and maybe not including it. So you put a little round circle there, and then this, we could say this is supposed to be that this is the interval from minus infinity to 5, and again round bracket because we didn't include the 5, we put a little circle there to show it's not, the 5's not in, and that's all the numbers that are less than 5. And so that gives the picture and the notation for how to work with intervals. Okay, so again we have square brackets when we include the numbers. The square bracket 3, 5 notation means all the numbers from 3 to 5, including 3 and 5. These are all the numbers from 3 to 5, but not including 3 or 5, just the ones in the middle, in between 3 and 5. This is including 3, not including 5, but including all the numbers in between 3 and 5, including 3 but not 5, including 5 but not 3, and all the numbers in the middle. Okay, so that's our notation for intervals.